Hi, in this video we will study probability calculations for normal distributions. The probability density function for the normal distribution is the one listed here, in which the sigma is the standard deviation, and this Greek letter mu is the mean, which is the expected value. So if this is the standard deviation, then the sigma squared would be the variance for this type of distribution. This is the way that we're going to indicate that x follows a normal distribution, which is also called a Gaussian distribution. But most cases we just call it a normal distribution. So when we say x follows a normal distribution with mean mu and variance sigma squared. Now, like we did in class, we know that it's not that simple to work with this type of function. Then we have what we call the standard normal distribution, for which mu is 0 and sigma equals to 1. And we have in the textbook a table. Let's see where I have the table. It looks like this on page 87. We have a table that looks like this, that has the cumulative distribution function of the standard normal distribution. So let's review this. This is the normal distribution, what we call the standard normal distribution, when we had the values of mu equals 0 and the variance equals 1. So in that case, we have already some answers in this table. Like we have, for example, because this is the cumulative distribution, and then we use this symbol phi of x to indicate the area under the bell shape, under the normal distribution, which is called the bell curve, to the left. So in this case, from minus infinity up to x is whatever is this area. We can find it in this table. For example, if we say x is negative 0.24, let's say 6. So the way that we go and look is we're going to look for, I'm saying negative, right? So negative 2.4 is here, and then I look on the table under 0.6 and I get this answer. So then this will be 0.069, which means that the area to the left will be this value. And if I want to know the area to the right, then what we do is 1 minus this number. Okay, so these are two pages. So for example, if I'm concerned about this table, it consists of two pages. If I'm concerned about the phi of, that's how we pronounce this symbol, the phi of, let's say, 1.78, and this is what I want to know, then we go and look for 1.7 in the table, in the second page of the table, because in the second page of the tables are the positive side. So this, since this is has a mean of 0, so the 0 is here, so we have in one page the negative values, which will be all the values to the left of the mean, and then in the second page we got all the positive values, which is all the values to the right of the side of the mean. So in this case, if I'm looking for 1.78, 1.78 is, here is 1.7, and then I'm looking for 0.8 right here, and then I find the number, which is 0.9625. So that's how we find it. Okay, now there is another piece of information that is on this table, which is the critical points, these alphas. And you see here in the diagram is the area to the right. Like for example, let's suppose that we want to find a value in which the area to the right will be, let's say in this case, 0.1. So then it says here that is 1.82. The problem that we have here, I mean, if another way is that I will be looking for, if this is the area to the right, then the area to the left of this point will be about 0.9. So I will have to look on the table something that is the closest value to 0.9, and maybe I don't have the exact 0.9, so that's where we got the critical point. So you see here I got an 89.77 and 0.9215, so it should be someplace there. So look, if I look for 1.282, so 1.28 is this. So that means that the 0.9 is between these two values. So the 0.9 is between these two values, which is actually 1, and this information is 1.28. So that means the area to the left, that is 0.9, in this case, if I'm looking for that 5, that will be this. However, I don't have this precision, I don't have those three decimals to look on the table, right? So this is also useful. So the area to the right of that number will be 0.1, and the area to the left will be 0.9. So in this case, the 0.025, the area to the right will be 1.96, and to the, the area will be to the right will be this, and to the left it will be 1 minus this value, which is going to be close to 975, right? So, or let's see, let's look for this one. So if this is the area to the right is 0.1, let's see what we have on the left for 2.32. 2.32, this is 3, and then this is 2. This is about 0.9898, so the 2.236 makes sense that it's going to be the 0.99, and that will be 1 minus this value. Okay, so that's the difference. So this may be useful in some type of problems. Now, if we need other information that is not listed in the table, either we give an approximation or we use some type of software to figure out an approximation, or we do the integral, which is maybe something that we don't want to do because it maybe takes some time. Okay, so now let's work on some exercises like the one that are on the textbook. Let's go and look for how is that they are solving this set of exercises. So let's go with 5.11. So the first question is, suppose that we have a variable z that follows a normal distribution, but when we see that there is a 0 and a 1, then I know that this is a standard. So because this is a standard, then I just need to look for this information on the table. So let's see. The first question, I'm looking for, so for this first question where it says the probability of z being less or equal to 1.34, because this is less, we just concern about the area on that is to the left of 1.34, which in that case will be just looking for that on the table, and the way that we express that is we're looking for phi 1.34, which is actually what they are asking here, and then we look on the table that is there and we should get this number. Okay, so now on part B, look that they are asking for the area to the right of this value. So in that case, we get the area to the left, and then we do 1 minus whatever this number is that we get from the table. Then we do the computation, and we should get this number. Let's see the next question that we have here. So in this case, we have an interval. So then we can just do a subtraction. So this is 0.43 and 2.19. So in this case, we can just do a subtraction of the phi of 0.43 and the phi of negative 0.219, so we can get that interval. And again, we get this information from the table, we get that information from the table, and then we subtract, and we should get this. Now, let's see for the question D. On question D, we have another interval. So on question D, for that interval, we should also do another subtraction of the values of those five functions. So these functions that we call phi functions, these are the ones that we get from the table, right? From the table that is on page 787, which is the standard normal distribution, and that table only works for a distribution in case that in the case of the mu equals 0 and the sigma equals 1. Okay, for the next question that we have is the E. So we got an absolute value. So in this case, when we solve the absolute value, we're going to have an interval that is from negative 0.38 to positive 0.38. And in that case, once that becomes an interval, then we can just find these values on the table again and subtract them and get this information. Okay, for the next question, what is the value for which we get this? So the way that we are supposed to get this. So for this case, the way that we can get the exact answer is either we use some software to get the inverse, or we just do some estimation using the table, because it's looking for the value of x in which we get an area to the left that is 0.55. So we can go and look and see if we can find something that it says that the area is 0.55. And then if you look at the 0.12, between 0.12 and 0.13, that's where we had that 0.55. So we say that it's going to be 0.12 something. If we use software, we can actually get the right answer, which is 0.12257 to get the inverse of the function. Otherwise, we were able to get the 2.12, and then we can just do some type of estimation there. Okay, this is similar to the other question, which is, now I want to know the value of f, but in this case, they're asking me for the ones in which the area to the right will be 0.072. Now in my table, I got the area to the left. So I want to find the area to the left, that will be 0.28. And then again, if I use some software, I can find that the inverse in this case will be negative 0.05828. So if you look at the table, the -58 is between these two values is where we have the 0.28. You see, we don't got the exact value, but from the table we can get an estimating that is -0.058. So I mean, estimated over there it will be fine, but the exact answer in this case will be -0.05828. Now the last question, we got this that says solve this, but we know that this will be the area to the left and to the right, and then those two areas are equivalent. One is one minus the other, because this curve is symmetrical. So whatever is the area to the left and right, like for example x, and then here x negative x, the areas to the left in this side and the area to the right to that x are equivalent because of the symmetry of the curve. So for that reason, then we can substitute this, one of them as being, I mean, this being 1 minus the phi of x. In that case, we're going to get 2 times phi of x minus 1. And then for that, it has to give us the value of 0.31. So by simplifying this expression, again, we're looking for an x, value of phi. I mean, once we simplify that, I mean, that give us this result. So when we further simplify, because we got 2 times this minus 1 equals this, so 2 times when we move this negative 1, it will give us plus 1 and 0.31, we get this. And then if we divide those two sides of the equation by 2, we get this. So we're looking for an x that will give me an area to the left of 0.655. And this, if we use software to get the exact answer, we get this. Otherwise, by using the table, we can approximate and see that on 0.39, we got the 65.17, and then in the other side, we got the 65.54, so it's between those two values, and the actual value is 3989.